here we go again. Robinhood, the app that originally brought us free stock trading, aka the app that robbed from the rich and gave to the needy, just became the number one name in irony. But on a serious note, first thing I want to say is I don't want to scare you, I don't want to alarm you, because not everybody was affected by this, but recently I've been getting a ton of messages on Instagram about people saying that there's something weird going on with Robinhood, so I wanted to make this very important video announcement explaining exactly what is going on. Because if 2020 could not get worse, it just did. So some people have been reporting that when they put money into the app,
and it's gone.
Now, I wish I could laugh at that, but almost every single day for months and months now, some user accounts have been systematically compromised. So if you use the cash management feature within the app and you have this debit card like I do, then your money could have been stolen without you knowing it. And even if you don't have this debit card and you don't have the cash management feature enabled, then that could have been enabled for you without you knowing about it. Some people have reported exactly that, and some of the money within their purchasing power has gone missing. That is money that sits in your account uninvested. And on top of that, worse still, some people have reported that their stocks have gone missing from their portfolio and have been sold out without their say-so. And unfortunately, Robinhood doesn't really have a direct customer service line to speak to, so they haven't really publicly addressed this, which is why I'm making this video. So I'm going to show you exactly how to find out if you've been affected and how to set up your account so that this does not happen to you in the future. So here's how this has been happening. First, the hacker gets access to your email. And this happens all the time by clicking some random pop-up or something you saw on Facebook, or you downloaded some random Google Chrome extension. And when this happens, now that they have your email account, what they'll do is for step two, they'll go inside your email, they'll find an email from Robinhood, and they will either delete all of them and or mark it as spam. Now this sends all of the future emails into the spam folder from which you will never get a notification from, which is important for step three, which is when they go to the Robinhood website and they type in your email address and they reset your password. That prompts Robinhood to send an email to you resetting your password. But because it's in the spam folder, you will have no knowledge of this happening. Now here's where you have your last line of defense via something called 2FA, two-factor authentication, which I'll show you in a moment how to set that up. But if you have that turned on, one of two things will happen. If you have the SMS version enabled, the text edition, what will happen is you will get a text sent that is the 6-digit code to verify your login. Now at this point, the hacker shouldn't be able to do anything because they would need that text. But there's a way around it via something called a SIM swap hack, which is a very real thing that happens to people, and I'll show you how to prevent that from happening to you later in the video. The second thing that could happen is you get a notification from a third-party authentication app that says your 6-digit code is now ready. Now with this option, the hacker should not be able to do anything unless they physically have access to your phone and passwords. Now if you do not have 2FA enabled, well, it's as easy as clicking that link, resetting your password, and now they have full total access and control over your money. At which point, they just link their bank account to your app and they can transfer your purchasing power into their bank account or start selling stocks and then using that money to fund their bank account as well. Now, if you do not have the cash management feature turned on, in theory, they could turn it on and you'd have no idea if that happened or not, because you're not getting any notifications about it, so they could abuse that as well. Now luckily, Robinhood follows very strict AML, which is anti-money laundering laws, which requires Robinhood to have the money that is sent from your bank account into the app to be 2 months old before it can be sent to a new bank account. So that helps a little bit, but there's ways around that too. Because if you're somebody like me who doesn't use the app every single day, you might not know that your account was compromised at all and you might not see the notifications. At which point, all they have to do is send the money over to the app, wait 2 months, and then transfer it over to their bank account like that. So when I read about this, I got really scared because I know I'm a pretty big target being a social media person and I show my account all the time. So I'll show you in this next part of the video, it's very important how to figure out if you've been affected and how it works. I know it might seem obvious, like, Andre, I know when I've been hacked, I could see my money's missing, but that's not true for everybody, especially for somebody like me with a small or a relatively modest sized account. I would not be able to tell right away because if a couple thousand dollars are missing, maybe that's the stock market doing its thing. every day my account fluctuates thousands of dollars up and down because that's what the stock market normally does, so I would have no way of knowing about it immediately. So here's how you can find out. Open the app and go to the little person icon on the bottom right, then click on Statements and History and click Show More. And here it's going to show you everything from interest payments to dividends that you've received, free stocks from friends you've invited, but more importantly, it's going to show you the orders and transfers, or you could just look at all of your history. So for me, for example, I could see that I made $12 on August 31st from an Apple options call. And I know I did that, so that's a good sign. The most recent thing I did was I purchased the EPD stock. Now, if you notice anything out of the ordinary, then that's a good sign that something is fishy. But you want to scroll down a little bit further just to check that you weren't hacked a couple months ago. That's very important. Now, this usually happens late at night or early morning when people wake up and notice that they got a ton of messages from Robinhood of the 6-digit code and they didn't ask for it. So if that happened to you, there's a chance that somebody tried to break in. Now, hopefully this did not happen to you because I know that losing your money is the worst feeling in the world, but if it did, there's a few ways of going about this. And the first, of course, is to reach out to them directly, which I realize is ironic, but if you go to robinhood.com/contact, you can do that there or directly in the app. And all you have to do is go to the person icon in the bottom right, and all the way at the bottom, you'll see help. So click on that. Then the second option, contact us, click on that. And then again, second option, my account and login. Click on that as well. And the second to last, you'll see my account was compromised. So once you click on that, you'll see these two little articles about how to prevent this, but all the way at the bottom, continue to agent. Once you click on that, you can describe your issue and then submit. I'm really glad that they made this really intuitive and simple for people to find. You know what? I did a lot of digging, so if you want to skip all of that and email them directly, I actually found a direct email, and it's report@robinhood.com. Now, I do want to say, though, that I don't think Robinhood was attacked. I don't think their security was breached. I don't think their emails were hacked. As far as what I understand, it looks more like user error. And for now, Robinhood has been pretty good about restoring people's accounts back to normal and giving people back their stocks if they were sold off by some hacker. So this next part is very important, especially if you're not a tech-savvy person like my parents. I'll show you how to protect yourself because there's a right way of doing it and there's a wrong way of doing it. And unfortunately, Robinhood doesn't make a very clear distinction between the two. First, let's enable two-factor authentication. So go to the little person icon on the bottom right-hand side of the screen, click on settings, and from here you can see two-factor authentication. Click on that, and here's where we enable it. If you don't have it on, turn it on right now. But you see how I have SMS enabled? That's not a good thing. What that means is the next time I get a code, it will text me that code, but people can steal my SIM card directly from my phone carrier and receive all of my texts. Now, I knew about this before, but I was just too lazy to change it, so let's do this the right way. First, download the Google Authenticator app. It's the only app I trust 100% of the time, and if you already have 2FA enabled in Robinhood, but you use SMS, go ahead, disable it, and then enable it again, and then start from scratch and reset it like this. So you're gonna see SMS, Google Authenticator, Authy, 1Password, or some other authentication app. Please use Google Authenticator. Now, at this point, it's going to ask if you want to launch and open the app, and click open, you're going to see a new token. This is Robinhood. And here, you're going to see 6-digit codes that are refreshing in the background every 30 seconds. You have 30 seconds to copy this code and enter it back in Robinhood. So once we do that and we hit next, we're going to see it's going to give us a backup code, an emergency backup code that you absolutely need to write down. And this is because if you're somebody like me, and I'm an idiot, I lose my phone all the time, you need to have this code that you're going to input later in order to restore access back to your apps. Please make sure to do this for all of your accounts that are sensitive, like your bank accounts, your credit card accounts, your brokerages, and if you already have the 2FA enabled, but it's set to SMS, the text message feature, don't be lazy. Pause this video right now and change that to the authenticator method. Now, here is a big pro tip. This is extra credit, but what you want to do is you want to call up your service provider for your phone and you want to tell them exactly this.
Hello, AT&T. Please make a note on my account. I must be physically present in order to get a new SIM card, and I must be physically present at one of your store locations in order to pick up said SIM card. In fact, I don't want you to ever order and ship a SIM card on my behalf if I call and verify that it is me to any address ever. I must be always physically present. What's that? Oh, you want me to email you?
All right. Yeah, please email them instead. But the real reason you're doing this isn't so much because you don't want to get hacked, it's because if you are SIM swap hacked, now you have evidence and legal liability protection that you gave them specific instructions which they broke, at which point they now have full legal responsibility to make you whole again. And this is very important because a guy I know in person, Michael Turpin, has had millions of dollars worth of Bitcoin stolen from his account. He sued AT&T successfully for over $100 million. But I'm guessing since you and I are nowhere near his wealth level, we can't afford to hire dozens of lawyers. So this is my pro tip for protecting ourselves, but better yet, just use the Google Authenticator method to verify. But regardless, if you do have time, send that email and thank me later. Now, if you want to do some extra homework to protect yourself, which I strongly recommend that you do, then please stop using passwords like password 123, stop writing them down physically or in your notes app like my parents, and instead get yourself a password generator / backup service like 1Password. I use them all the time. And the way that it works is you just memorize 1Password and it stores and collects all of your passwords and it makes them extremely complicated. And it has an automatic fill feature that does it all for you. I'm not sponsored by them. I'm not affiliated with them. It's just a really cool app. And secondly, and I'm mostly talking to my mom here, but mom, please stop clicking links that are like, find out why your horological sign is lucky this year. And stop using Facebook, stop using their games, stop clicking those links and articles and news because that's how your account gets compromised. I mean, you could use social media if you want, but just use a different email account that you use for social media for all of your really important money stuff, unless you're really tech savvy. Now I want to speak directly to Robinhood. I'm not sure if they watch my videos, but if they do, Robinhood, please just hire more staff, more customer service reps, more technical support, and please implement a little feature with a chat box where we can just send our messages in and then have a response quicker than waiting a few days, because by that point, it's just too late. And we shouldn't have to say it, but we shouldn't have to see our money dwindle all the way to zero before we're taken seriously. And Robinhood knows this as well as anybody else. The stock market moves very quickly. And if you're in some crazy options trade, or if your account was frozen, then by the time that issue is resolved, then it's too late and a lot of money could have been lost, or worse still, somebody's life, unfortunately. I really wish I didn't have to make this video, but now might be a good time to consider switching to Geico. Just kidding. I'm not sponsored by anybody, but if you don't want to use Robinhood, then that's understandable. And if you want to support my channel, there's a link down below where you can switch to Webull. And if you deposit $100 into their account, you'll get 2 free stocks valued no less than $8 a piece and up to $1,600 each. You can also follow me on Instagram. I post from time to time. Join my free Discord group if you want to send me your Pokemon cards, PO box down below. Love you. I will see you very soon back here on Monday and Friday, sometimes a Wednesday. Stay safe, take care of yourself mentally, physically, and financially, because 2020 be creeping. Take care.